Welcome to our channel Elimika Mtandaoni. My name is Agustino Mogosi. We are in the third lecture on electronic and mobile commerce, and today we'll be talking about a framework of electronic commerce and the classification. Actually, the field of electronic commerce is very diverse. It involves many activities, it involves organizational units and even technologies. Therefore, a framework that describes its content can be very useful. So there are many electronic applications, such as we have a lot of electronic applications. To mention a few here, we could say we have what we call direct marketing. We have direct marketing. We have another electronic commerce application, like searching for jobs. If you search for a job, you are also doing an electronic application. We have some online banking. Online banking is another electronic commerce application. We have electronic government. We have electronic purchasing. We have business to business exchange. We have e-commerce. We have m-commerce. We have auctions. We have online publishing, consumer services. We have collaboration 2.0 web technology. So all these, we regard them as electronic commerce application. So to perform these applications, then companies need the right information. They need infrastructure and they need support services. That means to perform these applications, we need people. So people actually are buyers, the sellers, the intermediaries, or the information system people, the management people. All these people are needed to perform these electronic commerce applications. We also need public policies. For example, we need things to understand things about taxes. We need things about legal activities, the privacy issues, the regulations, the compliances, and even technical standards. So also we need marketing and advertisements, things like market research, things like promotions. We need things like promotions. We need things like web content. We need things like targeted markets. All these are needed to perform these electronic commerce applications. We don't just need that. We also need support services. Speaking of support services, we need things like order fulfillment, things like logistics, things like payments. All these are considered to be support services. Security systems and development all fall under support services. But we also need some business partnership. In here, you will find things like affiliate programs. We need things like affiliate programs. You say affiliate programs. We need joint ventures. We need exchanges. We need electronic markets and even consortia. So all these things are needed. But speaking of the infrastructure for electronic commerce, then it describes infrastructure for electronic commerce as it describes the hardware. It describes the hardware. It describes the software and networks that are used in electronic commerce. All these components, speaking of electronic commerce applications and even infrastructure, they need good governance practices. So good governance practices are required. This means these companies need to plan. These companies need to organize and to motivate, even to devise strategy, to restructure processes as they are needed to optimize the business use of electronic commerce models and strategies. So after you have understood that, then we can see electronic commerce framework to be are seen like this. As you can see here at the top here, we have electronic commerce applications. As we have said, these applications, they need right information, they need infrastructure and support services. So here you will find people, you will find public policy. They act as pillars. They act as pillars for these electronic commerce applications. Then after electronic commerce applications, there is where we need the infrastructure and support infrastructure. That means we need the hardware, the software, and the network equipments. So that is electronic commerce framework. Now let us talk about electronic commerce classification. A common classification of electronic commerce is actually by the type of the transaction and transaction members. So we talk about transactions and transaction members. Therefore, we have the major types of electronic commerce transactions. The major types of electronic commerce transactions, as we can see here, we have these people involved. For example, we have the consumers, we have the businesses, we have the employees, and the government. Therefore, we can have what we call business to business. That means transaction between and among organizations. For example, a dairy company buys most of its parts through electronic commerce and it sells its product to business and individuals. So that kind of business, that kind of electronic commerce classification, we call it a business to business electronic commerce. We have another one that is called the business to consumer. Business to consumer, we call it B2C, business to consumer. This includes retail transactions of products or services from business to individual shoppers. That means, since the sellers are usually retailers, then we can also call this kind of electronic commerce, we can call it electronic retailing, simply because it involves the business and the consumers, and the sellers are usually the retailers. Then we have another type, which is the reverse of that. That is consumer to business. That means at first we had business to consumer, but now we have consumer to business. People use the internet to sell products or services to organizations. It is also possible for individuals to sell products to organizations. Alternatively, individuals also can use consumer to business to request for bids on the products or services. So that is what we call a consumer to business. We have another classification of electronic commerce that is called business to employee. As you can see here, business to employee. This refers to the delivery of service, information, or products from organizations to their employees. For example, an instructor from the University of Dodoma can be studying at the University of Dodoma. That means it is the business that is done, the business to the employees. We have another one that is called the consumer to consumer. This one here is called the consumer to consumer. That means individual consumers sell or buy from other consumers. This includes individual selling computer online. For example, you can sell a computer online, and then you sell to another consumer. We have another classification of electronic commerce. It is called intra business electronic commerce. Actually, this refers to the transactions among various organizational departments and individuals in one company. For example, in a certain organization, if an organization has a department, let's say sales and marketing department, then the selling and buying is done within that particular department. That kind of electronic commerce, we call it transactions, we call it intra business electronic commerce. We have another type of electronic commerce, we call it collaborative commerce. That means online activities and communications are done by parties working to attain the same goal. that people collaborate. That means business partners design, let's say, a new product together. That is called collaborative commerce. That means they collaborate. They can collaborate at a remotely. That means people may be located in different places, but they collaborate to do a certain task for a business. That is called the collaborative commerce. We have another type of electronic commerce. We call it electronic government. That means a government agent buys or provides goods, services, or information from or to businesses. That can be called government to business or government to consumers. Then governments can deal also with other governments. If that is the case, that can be called government to government. So as you can see, those are the classifications of electronic commerce. We have discussed one type of electronic commerce, that is business to business. We had what we call business to consumer. We had what we call consumer to business. We had what we call business to government, government to business. We have government to consumer. We have consumer to consumer. We have government to employee. We have business to employee. We have what we call intra-business and collaborative commerce. So thank you very much for following Elimika Mtandaoni. My name is Agustino Mogos, and this is a lecture on electronic and mobile commerce. And today we were discussing about framework of electronic commerce and classification of electronic commerce. Don't forget to subscribe on Elimika Mtandaoni channel. Thank you.